Thank you very much. So I will speak about pseudo-randomness of binary sequences and lattices. There are several definitions of pseudo-randomness, but in my talk I will use the definition of Christian Modui and András Sárközi, since this definition is very useful in the applications. The reason of it is very useful for studying finite sequences. The previous approaches mainly studied infinite sequences. So binary sequences are usually zero and one sequences, but because of certain technical reasons, now all binary sequences will be minus one and plus one sequences. So Modui and Sárközi defined the well distribution measure and the correlation measure. These are on the slide. And both measures are expected to be zero for a real random sequence. It is because a real random sequence, every element of the sequence takes minus one and plus one with the same probability, and that's why we are expecting these measures close to zero. The well distribution measure studies the frequencies of minus one and plus ones in arithmetic progressions, and the correlation measure studies the connection between certain elements of the sequence. So what I told, that a sequence is considered as a good pseudo-random sequence if these measures are small, was said by Keszeny, Ferenczi, Modui, Riván, Sárközi. And the applications showed that a sequence is good if these measures are smaller than n to the power 1 minus epsilon. However, a sequence with these good upper bounds for their measure is good. The best constructions have much better pseudo-random measures. There are constructions where the square root of n times log of n factor can be achieved. Here, I just mentioned that n is the length of the sequence. So, next I show one of the most studied construction using the Legendre symbol. So this construction due to Hofstein and Lehmann, and they took a polynomial f of x and a prime p and defined the sequence of lengths p according to the values of the polynomial. The Legendre symbol may take minus one and plus one, and so now, because of technical reasons, I define the Legendre symbol 0 over p by 1. Usually the Legendre symbol is not defined for 0, but now I define it as 1. So this clearly, this sequence will be a minus 1 and plus 1 sequence. And on the slide there is a small illustration for a small example. In case of the prime p is 7 and the polynomial f of x is x squared plus 1. So Hofstein and Lehmann stated that this sequence has strong pseudo-random properties, but they didn't prove it. So in 2004, Guben, Modui and Sárközi proved that the well distribution measure and the correlation measure are very small. They are smaller than square root of p times log of p. And this is almost optimal apart from the factor log of p. And since then, several other constructions have been given, but still, this is one of the best. It is very natural, it has strong pseudorandom properties, and it can be generated easily and fast. So, I remarked that this construction was also tested by several tests of the National Institute of Standards and Technology by Riva, Modui and Sarkozy. They computed several measures by computer, but they also proved that if the sequence has strong well distribution measure and correlation measure, then several tests is almost passed. It means just the proved result was slightly weaker than what the test was stated, but very slightly, so the difference was very small, and it was a theoretic proof, not a computer proof. And this work was later continued by Merai, Rivan and Sarkozy. So I show you again the construction of Guben, Modui and Sarkozy, because later in my talk I will use these constructions. And so P, K denote the set of monic polynomials where the degree of the polynomial is less than the capital K in the index of P sub K. And in that way, for each polynomial, we get a sequence. And since the polynomial may take several different values, there are many, many sequences can be constructed by this way. So, this gives us a very, very large family. So let F sub K Lejeune define the family of all sequences obtained by this way that we use the Lejeune symbol, the polynomial F. Here the prime P is fixed, so I hope it is clear, this family. So, first I will study this family, and I mentioned that there were defined several measures for sequences, for independent sequences, but it is also important that a large family of sequences contain many, many independent sequences. So I just show an example. For example, it is possible we have many, many sequences etc. But the beginning of each sequence is the same and just the last few bits are different. So it starts with the same thing. It continues with the same thing, and only the last few digits, few elements are different. Then clearly, this family contains many, many sequences, but these are not really independent because apart from the last k elements, they are the same. In order to avoid this problem, several family measures were introduced, and the topic of my talk is the cross-correlation measure, and later I will generalize it to binary lattices. So, next I show you the cross-correlation measure. So, here you see the definition. At first sight, it is a bit difficult, but it is not so. The differential of the normal correlation measure now, it is that in the product E sub n plus d1, etc., E sub n plus dl, the elements are taken from different sequences. So, first, with Modulyi and Sarkozy, we defined the correlation measure of more sequences. So we have L different sequences of length n, and we consider a maximum where in the product A sub n plus d1, etc., A sub n plus dl are taken from the sequences an1, an2, etc., anl. Here, in the maximum, we have another condition that if two sequences are the same in the maximum, then di equals dg are not allowed. Again, the cross-correlation measure is the maximum of this correlation measure where the L tuples of sequences can be taken every possible way. So, since it is a quite difficult definition and other slides will also use, I wrote here on the blackboard and it is not confusing later. So phi f is the maximum where the sequence can be taken from the family, and we consider so this is the definition. The important sequencing is that these elements are from different sequences. For our first family, this sequence, this family has a very bad cross-correlation measure, and an easy example show it. So we consider three particular sequences. These are on the slide, and the cross-correlation measure of the family is greater than the correlation measure of the three sequences on the blackboard, on the slide. The correlation measure is a maximum, and the maximum is greater than every absolute value after the maximum, so that's why we have the second inequality. And it will be a product of Legendre symbols, and since the Legendre symbol multiplicative there will be a square after multiplying the Lejeune symbols, and this will be very big. So it shows there is a problem here, but with Modui and Sarkozy, we solve this problem by restrict our family to a subfamily of it. Namely, we consider only irreducible polynomials. And then everything worked perfectly. I just saw that here the main coefficient of the polynomial is zero, so the main term is x to the power k, and the next coefficient is zero, and after the polynomial continues. And it turned out there were no problem then, everything worked. So now I decided to generalize the cross-correlation measure to binary lattices. So what are binary lattices? I just show it by an easy illustration. The sequence can be illustrated by a rectangle, a long rectangle, and the binary lattices can be illustrated by a square, which contains plus ones and minus ones. Similarly to binary sequences, binary lattices also have many applications in cryptography. For example, they can be used in encrypting images or digital maps. So that's why I decided to generalize the cross-correlation measure for binary lattices. So here is the definition of the pseudorandom measure for binary lattices. So En square is the pair of the integers between 0 and n minus 1. Each x we assign the minus 1 and plus 1, and that will be a binary lattice. And so En square is the lattice point of this type. And we assign the minus 1, plus 1 to each lattice points, and that will be a binary lattice. A box lattice, if we fixed certain element of the lattice such that they formulate a box lattice B of the form on the slide, and we take the maximum of product of the binary lattice of the points of the box lattice. So similarly to the cross-correlation measure, the cross-combined measure can be defined a similar way. Just in place of one lattice, we use L different lattices, and in the products, the values are coming from different lattices. So we multiply eta 1 in the place x plus d 1, etc., up to eta L in the place of x plus d L. And the cross-combined measure is the maximum of these pseudo-random measures where the lattices can be taken any possible way. So I was looking for construction with good cross-combined measure, and my first idea was using irreducible polynomials. I will return to this slightly later. Just I show a picture from a binary lattice, one can easily obtain a binary sequence by taking the row of the lattice successively each other. So the first row is the first elements of the sequence, then we will continue the second row of the lattice, etc. And we started to study the connections between the binary lattice and the binary sequence by Modulyán-Sárkózy, and we proved that it is not true that if the sequence has strong pseudorandom properties, then the lattice also has. But in the reverse direction is not so. If the lattice has strong pseudorandom properties, then if the lattice has strong pseudorandom properties, then the sequence always has very strong pseudorandom properties. The connection is a simple inequality. Here the constant factor depends on the only the degree of the correlation measure, on the order of the correlation measure. So this was generalized by me for the cross-correlation measure and the cross-combined measure, and everything worked the same way as in the in the correlation measures. So it is a very good way to construct strong families with strong cross-correlation measure. We construct a two-dimensional construction, and we will obtain from it a one-dimensional sequence, construction of sequences. So I decided to give construction of binary lattices, and I used quadratic characters and irreducible polynomials. So my first idea was using FP square and one variable polynomials, and it worked in that sense. I had the optimal bound for the cross-combined measure, but I met with the difficulty of construction of irreducible polynomials. So I changed to another construction using the Lejeune symbol and two variable polynomials. So the next construction is a very natural construction. We consider a two variable polynomials, and the binary lattice is defined by the value of the two variable polynomials and the Lejeune symbol. For this construction, I didn't obtain the optimal bound, which should have been square root of the measure of the binary lattice, which means p. So p was the optimal bound, but I couldn't prove that. But I proved a slightly weaker, but still much better than the trivial bound. So the optimal bound would be p times log of p. The trivial bound is p squared, and I found something midway. I proved the cross-combined measure of this family is p to the power c over 2 times the log of factor. Again, if every binary sequence we assign the, if every binary lattice we assign the sequence, then the construction also has a good cross-combined measure. So, my previous construction used irreducible polynomials, but two-variable irreducible polynomials. And two-variable polynomials can be easily generated. For example, polynomials of this form are always irreducible. This is an easy convex consequence of a theorem of a book of Rédei, a quite old book from 1967, theorem 282. It is a theorem about more variable polynomial rings and ideals in it. But what is behind these things is the Schöneman-Eisenstein criteria, which I wrote in my abstract. Namely, if you have a two-variable polynomials, it can be considered as a one-variable polynomial in Y. So you wrote it Pn x, that's a polynomial of x, times at y to the n, and pn minus 1 x times y to the power n minus 1, etc. p1 x y plus p0 x. So, and we are in Fp. Of course, in Fp there is only one prime p, but the variable x can be used as a prime. I mean, if x divides all polynomials in the coefficients, except the last one, and x squared doesn't divide p0x, then this ensures that all two-variable irreducible polynomial will be indeed irreducible. So here the division is the usual division between one-variable polynomials. So x is a one-variable polynomial, these coefficients are one-variable polynomials in x, and using the proof of Schöneman-Eisenstein, it will give us that these two-variable polynomials is irreducible. So, since this polynomial has a very simple form, it can be very useful in applications. And using these two-variable irreducible polynomials, we could get a good construction of binary lattices with nearly optimal cross-combined measures, and from this we can get a good family of sequences with nearly optimal cross-combined measure. So that was all that I would like to say, so thank you for your attention.